We're going to skip Ask PD for today. We're going to look once again at Luke 18. Stay tuned. At the end of Luke 18, we have this interesting story. To be honest, I was having some difficulty trying to do an Ask PD today. I was having some difficulty even just trying to put this together. But then I came to Luke 18 once more. I was just reading that and saying, Lord, what am I supposed to say? What am I supposed to be speaking on today? What am I supposed to be sharing? I'm looking at Luke 18, noticing the pattern we find in this world, and really this question of what do we strive after? Notice what it says in Luke 18. This is about the wealthy ruler. He's talking to Jesus. As my Net Bible has it titled, the wealthy ruler. And he's talking about what he must do to inherit eternal life. And by the way, that question is a simple one. The answer is always faith in Christ. Faith in Christ and his finished work on the cross. I know man tries to accomplish it by himself, as the wealthy ruler or the leader did here. He begins to talk about the fact that he has kept the law. And we have that in our own day and age, don't we? That people keeping the law, the moral law, or a moral code, if you will, that I am basically good. Jesus, of course, then hits this point about the fact. He says this, one thing you still lack, verse 22, sell all that you have and give the money to the poor, and you will have treasure in heaven. Then come follow me. When he heard that, of course, he was very sad. It says, because he had many possessions. He was extremely wealthy. He begins to expound on that, and Peter makes the remark in verse 28. He says this, look, we have left everything we own to follow you. Jesus then said, I tell you the truth, there is no one who has left home or wife or brother or parents or children for the sake of God's kingdom who will not receive many times more in this age and in the age to come eternal life. My thought was this. We see the wealthy man, he says, I've done all of these things. I've kept this moral code. Jesus says, do this one other thing. Come follow me. And I guess we can approach this on two fronts. And these are two thoughts that I have. The first thing is that how many people in our world are not making that choice to follow him? They are so satisfied. They have a moral code, so to speak. They live a good life. But they won't make that next step to follow after Christ. And you know, we ourselves as believers are an important part, I think, in that process or in that situation. As Romans talks about the fact of preaching, of sharing about the gospel message. And it says, how will they hear unless they preach? Unless we come and speak that message. And faith comes by what? By hearing. And so I think it's an important part that we play in sharing that message. There's so many as well that aren't willing to make that step, what, to follow after him. We have a good moral code, but we're happy with what we have here rather than choosing and giving up whatever it might be to follow after Jesus. I guess for us as believers, my other thought was this, is that what, he wouldn't give up those things. And Jesus, he says, there is no one who has left these who will not receive many times. And I think sometimes we get bought into this lie that the things that are here bring me happiness, bring me satisfaction. And we're not willing to step outside that comfort zone, not willing to take that next step in following after Christ. I don't know what that might be. I know I was there at one point in college when I was trying to determine what I was doing with my life. And you know, I felt the Lord pushing me towards a direction of ministry, but I was not wanting to take that step because of fear of the unknown, of my inadequacy, of public speaking. I was deathly afraid of public speaking, and I still get the jitters yet today on those things. What's that next step, though? What are we holding on to here and not following after Christ? He's called us to this, and he's promised that what we find in here and chasing after him and following after him, imitating him, as Peter says, being holy as he is holy, we find greater satisfaction, greater joy, greater fulfillment in those things than we do in anything that we can find in this world. So what things are you grasping tightly? What things are you holding on to that Jesus is saying, you know what? You need to let go of those things. Come follow after me. Come walk in obedience. Come walk in faith. I have something better. Trust him. After all, he is, it says, our Abba Father. He is our good Father. He is the good shepherd. We can trust him. We can trust his plan. We can trust that as we step out in faith to do what he has asked us, that he will supply the strength, that he will give us grace, and that we will find ourselves much happier and a greater joy than anything we can find in this world. What a change from what I was originally going to talk about. I pray those things encourage you today. Maybe you need to challenge someone else with those words. Someone else from this chapter, chapter 18, here in Luke. Let's let go of the things that are here. Strive after him and after what he has called us to. Let's walk in faith. Until tomorrow, friends. Have a blessed day.